Could I just start with your name, rank, and duty title?
Yeah, I'm Colonel Rob Burgess, 07th Operations Group Commander.
Okay. So tell me just a little bit about what's going on here today, such as where you flew out of, everything it was doing at AMORG. And
what you see here today is the end result of about 4 months of effort from maintainers from Minot and Barksdale and Tinker Aerospace and returning a B-52 to service. And it's been over almost 10 years since the jet had flown, or over 10 years since the last sortie. It took about 4 months of effort to get it ready to fly. Flew it out today, it flew great. Great testament to the people who work for this airplane.
Okay, sir. So what's exactly, for some of the people who may not exactly know, what's the historical significance of this operation?
Well, it's a history-making event. There are airplanes that have a useful service life. They serve it, they get retired out of service, in this case to Tucson, Arizona, to the desert. And to have one come back into service is a really historic event. You know, it happens every day. It's great to give something back to the country, back to the taxpayers.
Okay. So, and in terms of what bringing this this B-52 out of the boneyard contributes to the bomber enterprise as a whole, what's the significance of that? What does it bring? What does it bring back to the fight that we didn't have?
It brings an important national asset back to the fight. So, with so many B-52s, right? And to bring one more back to the fight is a great benefit to the enterprise.
What were some of the challenges of regenerating the aircraft, both on the maintenance side and on the flying side?
Well, the maintenance side was definitely the biggest challenge. It was 4 months of work. Every system has been went through. All the engines have been taken off and installed. Every system has been checked out thoroughly. It took me and my crew about 3 days to go pick it up. I didn't coach travel there and back, so it was a very short, pretty small effort on the aircrew side, but a huge effort on the maintenance side.
So what were some of the special precautions that were taken during the flight? Was there different altitudes, different speeds, just some of the, maybe something different with the egress systems? What were some of the special things?
The biggest difference for us is we left the landing gear down the entire flight. The landing gear was not checked, and we tracked it out there for maintenance, and so it was locked down the entire flight. Otherwise, it's pretty uneventful for us. We only had 3 ejection seats armed, 3 aircrew. And all in all, it was pretty uneventful flight for us.
Okay, so tell me a little bit about some of the involvement of the 307th personnel in regenerating B-52. Why were you and some of the other reservists that were out at AMOR chosen to in this in the part of the regeneration?
Well, I think first of all it was a command-wide effort. Minot personnel, Barksdale personnel, personnel from Tinker, active duty and reservists. And I think in the effort to get a cross-section of personnel, we reached into the reserves for some of our expertise that we had. So I have a lot of experience in the airplane, so do all these other guys that flew with me today. And I think we just got a cross-section of experience from active duty.
And so, lastly, one of the things is, what does the regeneration of this aircraft mean in terms of, you know, demonstrating the longevity of the airplane?
Well, it's an amazing testament to longevity. This airplane was built in 1960. Flew for however many years, was retired for 10 years, now back into service. It flew quite a bit flew today for us. So it's a great testament to what product we have in the B-52. It's a great testament to the airplane.
All right. Is there anything else you'd like to add before we wrap it up?
I think so.
All right. Sounds good.
Barkley, 11th Bomb Squadron here in Barksdale.
Okay.
Right, yeah, kind of looking off camera.
Okay. Yeah, so it was about, it's only the second time it's ever been done. Last time was about 4 years ago in 1007, call sign Ghost Rider, Ghost Art.
Now, were you part of that?
I was not, no.
Okay. How does it feel to be part of this?
Definitely very privileged to be able to do this. It's something that certainly doesn't happen every day. It may never happen again.
So, my understanding is you guys flew with wheels down and at a slower speed and lower altitude than normal?
We did. We flew at 19,000 feet, about 250 knots, and we geared down at the safety ground locks in full time.
So, how was that? I know it's different from your other flights, but how was it flying a jet like that?
Uneventful.
Anything special about the flight that sticks out in your mind?
Other than just getting to do it, not particularly. It was interesting to see what systems worked after 10 plus years of not being serviced.
All right. Is there anything else you'd like to add?
No, I don't think so.
So, sir, can you give us your full name and rank and unit title, please?
Lieutenant Colonel Steve Miracle. I'm from the 10th Flight Test.
So, have you ever done anything like this before?
I was a part of the last one that we brought out. I FCF'd that airplane through the depot maintenance of the Tinker. But this is obviously the first time that I've flown on one directly coming from the water.
So when you say, I'm not familiar with the term FCF, what is that?
FCF is a functional check flight, so after the airplane goes through program depot maintenance. It's a non-airworthy airplane. It's been taken apart in a million different pieces, put it back together, and the crew and I at Tinker there, we fly the airplanes and check them out, make sure that everything functions properly before we bring them back to the operational units.
Okay. And how does it feel to be a part of this kind of flight?
It's a neat opportunity. Every time you fly a B-52, you feel like you're flying a part of history. But this truly is, you know, something that's pretty unique and definitely a part of history. Looking at the other airplanes that are out there, it's neat to see one come back.
Okay. Anything that you found unique about the flight itself or anything uncommon?
It was boring, and that was perfect. That's what we like. If you're going to take an airplane that hasn't flown in 10 years, we got airborne on the very first try, which is outstanding. That's a testament to the hard work of the maintainers that are out there to the A-mark still. But once we got that airplane in the air, everything went as smooth as can be expected, and we really didn't have any issues. It was an easy flight.
Okay. Anything else you'd like to add? Or?
No, I appreciate the opportunity. I don't really have anything else that I can think to talk about.
All right.
Thanks.
Thanks.
Go in. What's that?
Bus.
We'll see if they're ready to wrap it up, and we'll head back in.
The job that I do at Tinker is we take totally unairworthy airplanes that have been all taken apart, and there are very specific checks that we have.